Really?
I knew it was her right away. I told her that I was married to him and that. And she's like, oh, that is still a lot here. He's like, you know what happens? It's good, I've never seen him alive anymore. She said she hadn't seen you for years.
Oh, no, I was probably going to.
I said, well, they. She asked what you guys did. You know, I said, we go golfing and we go for coffee and like that.
Isn't that pretty much it?
She didn't tell her I think she's going to be married.
She gets together with all that. No, I didn't. I had her second. She sat down and I.
Oh, she was at the
house.
Yeah.
Like, she sat down and I'm like, you taught me second grade. And she said, yes.
I always ask people to know that they're only putting in reference.
So grateful you made it here today. I'm Nathan Black, I'm the AMS principal, and we're in for a show tonight. Welcome to the Alexander Middle School and the Houston High School Pops Concert. There's a lot of work that's gone into here, a lot of passion. It's been fun walking, hearing it in the hallways, hearing it in the rooms. And so, but before we start out, I'd like to start with a few pieces of concert etiquette. For starters, can you please take a look at your cell phones and make sure that those are either off or on silent just during the concert so that doesn't disrupt the proceedings. Also, please note that if you do need to leave for any reason to be able to exit the auditorium, please wait between songs for breaks to be able to do that coming in and out so we don't have the additional noise distracting the performers. Now, a particular note, several of the songs are going to have solos. People have been working very hard for that. If you could please hold your applause for the soloists until the end of the song, Mrs. Pulvermacher, Mr. Seibel will be acknowledging those soloists at that point, and then you can give them the extra applause they deserve. But just a few notes as you're doing that, and during the songs, please make sure, also particularly for the students, not a time to be walking around. It's a great time. Let's listen and honor the performance that's on the stage. So today we're going to be here, we're going to start out, with Mrs. Pulvermacher and the 6th grade choir. Please give it up for them. Thank you.
Thank you.
first song was Together We Stand by Gary Barlow from the movie Boss Baby 2. This piece featured unison singing throughout the ensemble, and solos by Corbin Cook, Max Hanline, and Aubrey Elicami. Let's give them one more round of applause. The second song is When I Grow Up, arranged by Roger Emerson. This is a hit piece from the Telugu musical. This song features a solo and duet that will be sung by Audrey Van Horn, Natalie Krauss, and Cameron Dockley. Throughout the song, you will hear the duets at the beginning, as well as call and response calls and harmony parts. We hope you enjoy our next piece, When I Grow Up.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for being here tonight. I am extremely proud of this group in front of you today. They've come a long way this school year, and this last concert, I wanted to make sure that I featured some soloists. And with the two pieces that I had for soloists, they all auditioned, and 11 of the students, that's almost half of the class. Let's give them another round of applause for auditioning. We have one final piece, and Natalie's going to introduce that for us.
Enjoy preparing this hit piece for you, and hope you'll enjoy it as well. Thank you for joining us tonight for tonight's concert and for your support throughout the school year. Here's a sky full of stars.
Thank you. Sunday mornings were your favorite. Used to meet you down on Woods Creek Road. Did your hair up like you were famous, even though it's only church where we were going. Now Sunday mornings I just sleep in. It's like I buried my faith with you. I'm screaming at a God I don't know if I believe in, 'cause I don't know what else I can do. I'm still
patience.
I've been staring at the edge of a bottle of hog, and as I can remember, we don't even mind the rain. Or will we let the floors get wet? So much if the hardwood stains, 'cause we're collecting evidence of one remarkable storm. How wild it was to find it, finally feel the climate, instead of only staying dry and warm. Settle for the silence. days fade into a watercolor blur. Memories swim and haunt you, but look into the lake, shimmering like smoke, rises the moon.
Always looking in, will I ever be more than I've always been? 'Cause I'm tap, tap, tapping on the glass.
Amen.
Who will know? you're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing it, ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. 'Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all.
Heart, don't fail me now. Courage, don't desert me. Don't turn back now that we're here. People always say life is full of choices. No one ever mentions fear or how the world can seem so vast. Journey to the past.
I hope you're enjoying the show.
We are.
Speed this up here, this year a little bit. I told all the kids that I wanted up on stage in advance, so I didn't call them up one at a time. I value your weekends, and I want to make sure that you get home and enjoy this wonderful weekend ahead. So, as they're coming up here, I'm going to start with seniors. I timed this out earlier. There's only about 45 minutes to an hour, and then we'll get on to the last group. Just kidding. Okay, seniors, as I call your name up, come on up and stand next to me, okay? Genesis Abrahamson. I had Genesis in choir at AMS for 2 years. Then she went MIA during her first 3 years in high school until her senior year. I was very happy to welcome her back during her senior year. She's been a nice addition to a very strong alto section this semester. Good luck to you, Genesis, and keep singing. Emma Anderson. Emma started singing for me at AMS, and the one thing I remember about her was she was always smiling in class. For those of you that know her, know she always smiles and has a big heart and is always willing to help and take the lead. Speaking of lead, Emma shined this year in the musical The Little Mermaid as Ariel. She works tirelessly on her lines and singing. She was going off script before she was required to. She even took private singing lessons to better herself for the role. She is an amazing actor and set a great example for everyone else in the cast. This semester, she has taken on the role of helping me reorganize the entire choir music filing system as my choral assistant. Don't change anything about yourself, Emma. You're going to have a great and successful life ahead of you. Good luck to you, Emma, and keep singing. Rebecca Harsher. Rebecca has been singing in the choir program for most of the last 6 years with me, and I have to say, she is quite simply one of the loudest and most rowdy kids I have ever had. Of course, those of you that know her know that that is a big-time false statement. She went to New York City last year with the choir program for our choir trip and had a great time. I enjoy having her in class because she's someone who I can count on to be there on time, always listening and following directions. Good luck to you, Rebecca, and keep singing. Kashong Tang. Kashong is another one of those rowdy kids. Not. I heard Kashong sing for the first time in 7th grade at AMS. She had an amazing voice, and she disappeared when she got to high school. I kept reminding her frequently as I passed by her in the hallway that I missed her and her beautiful voice in choir and that she should come back. Well, eventually those reminders paid off. She came back for her senior year, not just in one choir, but two. I was so lucky. I wish I had her for a couple more years, as she was another no-worry, listened-well, followed-directions, super-kind person that makes my job so enjoyable. Good luck to you, Kashong. Keep singing. Gabby Levins. I'll never forget the day when this girl and her family walked into the choir room prior to her freshman year during the NHS open house. She was bubbly and excited to talk about her previous choir experience and how much she loved musicals. She is so unbelievably passionate about singing that she has sung in both choirs for a total of 9 semesters during her time here. She is a great vocal leader in whatever section I force her to be in. She has been, she's been in every musical since she arrived. And who can forget when she died of scarlet fever last year at the beach, just after a an amazing song with her big sister Jo during Little Women. My tears well up every time. She also hopes to enter the world of music education for her future career. I can't wait to see that achievement. Good luck to you, Gabby, and keep singing. AJ Rohr. Prior to AJ joining the choir this year, my only experience with him had been watching him get people fired up at pep rallies by breakdancing and enticing the entire crowd to do the wave. I'm sure some of you have seen that. But the way he stepped out of his comfort zone and joined choir this year is amazing. He displays leadership every day by the way he acts in the classroom, and we are glad to have him as a member of the guys section. Good luck to you, AJ. Keep singing. Drexel Sosnowski. Drexel and I met officially for the first time last year when he registered for both the intro and intermediate music theory classes as a junior. He was the only one that took those classes last year, so he was like an independent student, and he worked on his own and asked me for help and whenever he needed it, so he did really well. During that time, he would occasionally sit at the piano and play and sing. He had a really nice voice, as you learned earlier with his solo in the song Waving Through a Window. I asked him if he would consider joining the choir as a senior, and he said, yeah. He's a very talented musician. He plays piano. He's also a composer. He has written so many songs, including a piece for the Treble Select Choir that I hope to introduce next year. He has been a strong vocal leader and a welcome addition to the choir this year. Good luck to you, Drexel, and keep singing. And Ellie Tompkins. Ellie has sung in the choir program for me since seventh grade. She is a great leader by example. She never is a distraction in class. She's a rules follower. She's a very strong singer. She has been in 3 out of the 4 musicals during her time here, including the important role of one of the Mer sisters in The Little Mermaid this year. I'm looking forward to hearing where her future goes. Good luck to you, Ellie, and keep singing. Okay, on to the award section. I give out varsity choir letters every year. They have to achieve 100 points. They get 75 points for being in choir all year. They have to put in 25 points in other areas, being in a musical, singing in community or church choirs, private voice or piano lessons, participating in solo and ensemble, going to other concerts, band concerts, musicals, caroling, etc. The following people will be receiving their first year choir pin and letter. Just gonna call them all off in a row. They're gonna come up and you're gonna clap them once again, okay? Rachel Peterson, Prairie Milestone, Trinity Turbiatis, Sean Pang, Nash Kirchmar, Veronica Bedell, Michaela Andrews, Kamari Posh, Andrew Bedell, Elizabeth Fergus, Danny Smith, Lily Von Lowe. Solo Ensemble Awards. We participated in Solo Ensemble for the first time since pre-COVID. Yes? Did we do it last year too?
No.
Okay. All right. The following people performed at the district level and some at the state level. Veronica Bedell did a Class B alto solo and received a gold rating. Trinity Turbiatis did a Class A soprano solo and got a silver rating, a music theater solo and got a gold rating. Gabby Leverance, Class A soprano solo, gold star, music theater, gold rating. Ashlyn Wilcox, Class A alto solo, district gold, music theater, district gold star, music theater, state gold, oboe solo, district gold star, state oboe solo, silver. Michelle Shannon, Class A alto solo, district gold star, music theater, district gold star, Class A alto solo, state gold, music theater, state gold. Okay, last two awards. Nakusa High School Choral Award and the National School Choral Award. First one, Nakusa High School Choral Award goes to the individual who displays leadership, passion, and ownership in the choir program, consistently goes above and beyond the teacher's expectations. The recipient this year exemplifies all of the characteristics of this award. This student has sung in multiple choirs during their time, including a total of 9 semesters. There are only 8 semesters total at the high school. They performed 2 songs at the district solo ensemble and made to the state level with their soprano solo. They were selected to attend the prestigious Dorian Vocal Festival, the WCDA All-State Choir, and the South Central Conference Honor Choir this year. They have taken both the intro and intermediate music theory courses. They love singing, constantly working to improve their craft. They make people around them better singers, and they have been a wonderful asset to this choral program. The Nakusa High School Choral Award winner this year goes to Gabby Leverance. Choral Award is the highest honor for a high school choral student. It recognizes the dedication and music achievement among the top choral students. The student has been in the choir program since 7th grade. The student is so passionate about singing. This person is a strong vocal leader in whatever section I put them in. They have taken their commitment up a notch this year, not only with their singing ability, but with their confidence. This person has taken 9 semesters of NHS choirs, including multiple choirs, multiple times. This person was awarded 2 gold stars at the district solo ensemble and 2 golds at state. This person has been in musical 2 years, both major roles. They were selected to attend the prestigious Dorian Vocal Festival this year as a junior, the first junior to accomplish that in my time here, as well as being named to the WCDA All-State Choir in January. This year's winner of the National School Choral Award is Michelle Shannon. Thank you. 7th and 8th grade, 6th grade, I'm sorry I didn't really get to hear you sing. I was back in the choir room, but I'm sure you did amazing as well. The treble selector is going to close out with, I'm sure, a favorite of many of you, Dancing Queen.